Hey, it's Dave. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I wanted to show a song called Eat That Question. It was just the riff. I actually got an email from an old student of mine who said to me that he loved the show and he was digging all the rants, but he wanted me to show him the riff to Eat That Question. I guess he looked up a bunch of tabs and he couldn't find something that he felt was right. So I figured I would do it. Today I'm playing my G&L. I gave my buddy back his yesterday. This one is a USA made. It is in clear orange. You'll notice that I have the two MFD Strat pickups in the neck and in the middle, and then a regular Tele MFD bridge in the back, or ASAT. And it's got the reverse headstock. It has a very big deep V neck, a fat V that I love, and it has the stainless steel frets. This was custom built for me. And just real quickly, I'd like to show you this groove, this riff. It basically starts like a, so we got open three on the low E, E to G, and then E, D, E. And then the next riff is, a lot of this song has a lot of pull-off riffs, so the next one is, and you end it with the A string open, so it's like, so together that's, and that's the first half of Eat That Question. The second half, it comes back in, he's like, A, B, C sharp, B, C sharp, so. And then the same type of riff. The tricky part is he comes back into this. So it's, comes right out of, slow, it's and then he slides down from the 12 and then the keyboard solo starts. Lately I've been listening to a lot of Zappa. I love the song Cheapness, and I've been listening to that. Now, you know, I'm really confused because there's a great version of Cheapness online where you hear like the girl background singers are really loud and it sounds really great. And then when I go back and listen to the record, he's got them so low in the mix. I don't know why he decided whatever it was that he decided to go against them being really loud. I thought it's much better in the video that's on YouTube. It's like rare studio footage, but you know, it starts out with a false start where they have to restart again and Frank does a whole shtick and then they do the whole song again. And it's just great. It's great. You know, I loved Apostrophe, that album. I love, like, all the stuff with Napoleon, Murphy Brock, and I like all the Ike Willis stuff. Just all great stuff. Anyways, I wanted to do something quick and short, get something up, and show my buddy Eat That Question. That's that. A lot of people wrote some great comments about the Steely Dan stuff I posted. Thanks so much. I love the band, and, you know, if I could think of other songs to do that I think are, you know, worthy of doing. Actually, I probably should break down at some point the solo to, I played it, but I didn't break it down. I played it in the Larry video for Don't Take Me Alive. That's just such a great solo, and there's some great stuff. Anyways, don't want to get too much involved. Just wanted to show that and get this up for you today. I got a gig tonight, and probably shoot something tomorrow. But that's about it. Very good.
You're right on the money. Everything you said. You're right on target. You hit the nail right on the head with your comments, what you're saying today.